Tropical rice for Fusarium wilt, or Panama disease as it is commonly known, is arguably the most devastating of all known banana diseases. It affects not only Cavendish, which is the main variety grown in Australia, but also other niche varieties such as Ladyfinger and Ducas. Tropical rice 4 is caused by a soil-borne fungus, which initially infects the plant through the roots, then moves through the plant into the vascular system within the pseudostem. It eventually blocks the vascular tissue, which causes plant death. Early symptoms of the disease typically include yellowing of the leaf margins, particularly in older leaves. This eventually leads to the death of the leaf margins, while the yellowing will continue further into the leaf. The lower leaves tend to wilt and form what can be described as a skirt around the plant. The younger leaves may remain green and upright. The stem of an infected plant may also split. Darkening of the vascular tissue within the stem is also likely. This darkening can range in colour from reddish to dark brown to black. Discoloration may not, however, always be immediately visible with early disease infections. Infected plants will rarely produce a marketable bunch, and the additional stress of producing a bunch usually exacerbates the symptoms. The fungus that causes tropical rice 4 produces spores that can be transported in soil, water, and plant material. These spores can survive in the soil for decades, even if all banana plants have been removed and another crop has been planted. So it's important to understand that regardless of what the land is used for, tropical rice 4 can persist in the soil and therefore can continue to spread unless effective biosecurity measures are enforced. Preventing tropical rice 4 from moving onto your property is the only way to maintain your current productivity. In Australia, tropical rice 4 was first detected in the Northern Territory in 1997 and virtually destroyed the commercial banana industry there. In March 2015, the presence of tropical rice 4 was confirmed in Tully, which lies within the major production region of North Queensland. There is currently no known chemical, biological, or physical method of killing the fungus responsible for tropical rice 4 in the soil. The spores of the fungus can be killed quite easily with some decontaminant products. However, this is only in the absence of soil. The persistence of the fungus in the soil has so far hampered every effort to eradicate the fungus and its spores. Preventing the disease from entering your property is therefore the only viable strategy currently available. Effective on-farm biosecurity practices are essential for minimising the risk of the disease ending up on your property. This includes identifying and assessing the risk pathways onto your property, implementing measures to limit these pathways, limiting movement onto your property, introducing the come clean, go clean concept for all staff, visitors, vehicles and machinery, training staff and visitors to ensure they understand and adhere to biosecurity measures, training staff to detect and report plants that they suspect may have the disease. In Queensland, Panama is by law a notifiable disease under the Plant Protection Act. Do not attempt to remove any potentially infected plants, as this may spread the disease throughout your property. Instead, record and mark the location of the plants, and if possible, take photographs to aid identification. If you suspect Panama disease is present on your property, report it immediately to Biosecurity Queensland on 132523. Remember, early detection and containment is critical to limit the spread of tropical rice 4. Effective on-farm biosecurity measures are currently your only defence against this disease. Adoption of these measures on all farms is vital for the future of the Australian banana industry.